Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're walking everyone through a little bit about coupling, decoupling networks, or CDNs, used for conducted RF immunity testing. On my left, you'll see three different CDNs. We're going to go ahead during the video today and walk through how to make the connections for the calibration process for conducted RF immunity testing to IEC 61000-4-6. Now, during the video today, we are going to use two different M-series CDNs as well as an AF series. And we're going to show everyone how to make the connections, what they want to do as far as adapters go, and what you want to be sure you're going out there and buying. That way you don't have to procure it later. On our right, you will see our Tesic NSG4070. That's going to be the conducted RF immunity test system we're going to use for today's video. So now let's go ahead and let's take a look at some of our CDNs and let's walk through some of the connections. All right, so here you're going to find a couple of the conducted RF CDNs. Starting from our right, you're going to find the CDN M2-M3. In the middle, you will see the CDN AF4. And then finally, on the far left, you will see the CDN M5-32-amp. So just as you would guess, the CDN M5-32-amp is used for three-phase five-line applications. The M2-M3 is used for single phase, so that's pretty straightforward there. Taking a look at the connections kind of on the back and front side of the coupling decoupling networks, you will notice it's color coded by lines. So you will see right here you have a blue, a yellow, a black. You're going to use those obviously for your power lines. When you do go out there and purchase these coupling decoupling networks, you want to be sure you are buying both, I believe they're commonly called mating adapters, as well as your 100 ohm impedance adapters. And this is going to be really important for IEC 61000-4-6 calibration. So when you do go out there, the mating adapters just slide right on in there, just like that. And then you go ahead and you add the 100 ohm impedance adapters right on the end there. And again, it just slides right on there and it should look something like that. So a very similar methodology is used for a variety of different coupling decoupling networks. So let's go ahead and I'll show you how the same thing is done with the CDN AF4. And you will notice here that this CDN is going towards the EUT on this side. So this will kind of give you a view on both connections. So if you do look at it, it is four lines. So you want to be sure you have a four line mating adapter, which should look something like this. You will see it goes from four lines just to one. All right, so all you have to do, same concept, is plug that right in there, just like that, and then go ahead and put on your 100 ohm impedance adapter right there on the back side of it. It should just slide right on there. All right, so those are the items you want to be sure you buy. Again, some of it will be included with it. Otherwise, you want to be sure you do order those 100 ohm source impedance adapters because you are going to need those if you are doing the calibration process and testing for IEC 61000-4-6. Let's go ahead and let's set up our conducted RF calibration setup in accordance with IEC 61000-4-6. And then let's go ahead and walk through some of the different connections and then walk through changing some of the different testing parameters and running the calibration. All right, here you're going to find the calibration setup using your Tesic NSG4070 as well as your CDN M2-M3 for IEC 61000-4-6. So this is going to be the kind of the starting point for testing. This is going to allow your system to ensure that it can meet those different test levels with your coupling decoupling network. So let's walk through the setup briefly. Starting from the lower left side of your Tesic NSG4070, you're going to see your amplifier out. That's going to your 6 dB attenuator, and then from your 6 dB attenuator, it's going to the input on your coupling decoupling network. As we mentioned previously, you will notice on both sides of the coupling decoupling network, on the right side right here, and the left side over here, you will see our 100 ohm adapters. On the right side, you will notice that we do have this terminated as well with a 50 ohm termination load, and then we have the output going right around here, going to your channel 1 power meter for your NSG4070. This setup is going to allow the system to store how much energy do I need to put in, how much power do I need to drive in order to meet those different test levels you select through the menu. So now let's go ahead and let's start up the Tesic NSG4070. Let's walk through some of the different criteria and be sure we are modifying it for coupling decoupling networks for IEC 61000-4-6. Here you're going to find the starting menu for your TESIC NSG4070C80. As we mentioned, we're going to be using this conducted RF test system today with our CDN. Let's go ahead and let's walk through the calibration setup. So let's click on immunity mode. Let's look at our test level. So right now we have 3 volts selected. You can go ahead and modify that if you go to test setup and test level and change that. So let's go ahead and change that to 4 volts. And let's change the stop to 4 volts as well. Alright, so now that has been entered, let's go ahead and hit back. We are using a CDN in accordance with IEC 61000-4-6. So you will see that indicated under coupling device. And we are using the 80 watt built-in internal amplifier. So if you do want to modify the coupling device, just hit coupling device and select the associated standard, so IEC 61000-4-6. And you can see the different injection methods listed here. You have CDN, EM clamp, current injection probe, and then finally, you have direct injection. We're going to go ahead and we're going to leave it at CDN today, and we're going to hit back. Now, taking a look just below that, you will see our sweep information. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to start from 150 kilohertz and we're going to end at 230 megahertz. And we're going to keep the dwell time at 1,200 milliseconds. All right, so you will see we do have the modulation off because we're running the calibration. Let's go ahead and let's run the calibration of our system and ensure it is storing the data for that 4 volts level. And we're going to go ahead and hit start calibration. All right, so you will see right now it's going through the frequencies, measuring the forward power required. Now we're going to go ahead and stop the video briefly and let the system run through the calibration, and then we'll start it back up. All right, so we just received the message indicating that the system calibration was completed successfully. That should just about wrap it up for the calibration. When you are ready to conduct the test itself, all you need to do is remove those adapters and connect your EUT, as well as select your modulation. We hope this video has been useful of how to implement coupling decoupling networks into conducted RF immunity testing for IEC 61000-4-6. Feel free to reach out to us if you're ever in need of any rental coupling decoupling networks or conducted RF test systems. Thank you.